in Shed Streets. Yeah. They were all burned to the ground in August 1968. And they were bullet holes, CLM holes. Charlie wouldn't have believed all publicity. He wouldn't have believed he would have got that much publicity.
Yeah.
He knew he was going to die. Persons in the IRA, they want to get into a house. Maybe three guys, four guys in the door every day, a certain house, safe house. And intelligence officer or operations officer would have came and said, okay, see this morning, these are blowing up a building in the city centre. We were under strict instructions to make sure nobody's killed. In 1972 alone, there were 1,600 bombs went off here, and there's 14,000 shooting incidents. Now, see if you take this place here, you put this in the corner in New York. You know what I mean? More happened here in West Belfast than happened anywhere else. Roughly between 70 and 94, 16,207 bombs went off, 37,000 shooting incidents. We had a fair number of British soldiers in the IRA, including ex-SAS men, special boat service men, paratroopers. And they told us what we already knew.
Because they were Irish people,
didn't you? Yeah, British Army. But who lived here, later joined the IRA. We kept a close watch. See the vast, about 97% of IRA men I knew thousands, were the best people I've ever met. You get the odd hellion. You know, you get the odd, but it was a very odd hellion, and he was always controlled. Because if Italian OC would have sent a couple of heavies over to kill, don't you even try.
And what was the role of the women in that?
The women were pretty much the same as men. I mean, a lot of women were in Cumann and Mon, but some were in the IRA. Now, having said that, the IRA, a few things were wrong. They killed 10 innocent Protestants at King's Mill, and they done it because the people down there were cheesed off innocent Catholics getting killed. But that was equally as evil.